To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Thank you, Brother Coates. Thank you so kindly. Another day's journey. We thank the male choir as well. In other words, he's saying he has some good days. Mm-hmm. He has some bad days. Amen. But his good days outweigh the bad days.
Yes, sir.
So we are grateful. We serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty God.
Amen. Thank you.
Those with their Bibles, please turn with me. Certainly in the pandemic, you need your Bibles in the pandemic.
Amen.
You ought to have your Bible. Especially these days, your Bible shouldn't be picking up dust. Especially in the days that we're living in. No excuse, we got it on our phone now. Psalm 31, the book of Psalms, Psalm 31, 19. And I'm reading from the New Living Translation. Psalm 31. I believe it's very, one of my favorites. Psalm 31:19. And you'll find these wonderful words. And we ask that you, in your downtime, on your devotion, we ask that you read the whole Psalm 31. But I just want to shine a light on the 19th verse. It says, How great is the goodness you have stored up for those who fear you. You lavish it on those who come to you for protection. Blessing them before the watching world. How great is the goodness you have stored up for those who fear you. Father, I come now. First, I say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
You're mighty good to this preacher.
Yes, Lord.
But I come, Lord. Humble as I know how.
Jesus.
Because I need you, sir.
Yes, Lord.
Have thy way with me, Lord. Hide me behind your cross. That I may preach your word, Lord. With truth and power, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And the Holy Ghost power. Oh, Father God, send a fresh anointing, not only for me, Lord, but anoint your people afresh, Lord, that they can clearly hear your word, Lord, and be doers of your word, Lord, and apply the word to their life, dear God. And Father God, when it's all over, Lord, we will continue to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praises. It is in Jesus' name that I pray. I want to leave with you, church, a subject or a thought. Do you know anything about stored up blessings? I want to talk about stored up blessings. This is a writing of King David. David is a little older now. He's up in age. But David in the text says that he has trouble on every side. If you go back and read the whole text, you see he has trouble on every side. And if you read the text further on, he said he felt like a broken vessel. Have you ever felt that way, like a broken vessel? He felt like an empty pitcher. Have you ever felt that way? Satan will try to steal your joy, even in advanced age. He don't care how old you are. He still try to come in here and steal your joy.
That's right.
King David came to an almighty God as he was going through, and you ought to go to God. And David came to God with his prayer or petition because things not going well in his life right now. And if things not going well, who better to go to the Lord?
That's right.
David went to the Lord with his petition, asking God for deliverance from his situation.
Yes.
But he went to the right man.
Yes.
He went to God. If you would notice also in the text, David moves from prayer or petition to praise and worship.
Amen.
In the same breath.
Amen.
That's what God wants to take the church here. Moving from prayer or petition to praise or worship. That's what David did. Yeah. How great is your goodness?
Yes.
But you have stood up for those who fail you. Even though David does not see the blessing yet now.
Mm-hmm.
Even though he sees no evidence.
Yes.
But he said, David said, what David is saying, what David is saying, preacher? David said, I got a blessing. Yes. Put my name on it.
Yes.
That's all David did. I got a blessing. Although I can't see it,
that's right.
But I got a blessing. Put my name on it. That's what David is saying. David, confidence is not in man.
Yes.
His confidence is not in mankind. His confidence is in the Almighty Lord.
Yes.
His confidence is in God who made the heaven and the earth.
Yes.
David is not working on his own ability, nor his own wisdom.
That's right.
He's not coming in his own strength. He's letting God know that I know you have a heavy Lord.
Yes.
And you got a blessing for me, stored up just for me.
Mm-hmm.
So what did David tell the church? That God got the perfect timing.
Yes, it does.
To bring down stored up blessing.
That's right.
Afterwards, David was saying, I got a feeling.
Yes.
Everything's gonna be all right. That's what he did.
Yes.
He said, I got a feeling.
Right.
Although I don't see it now. But I got a feeling everything's gonna be all right.
Jesus.
See, what's for you, it's for you.
It's for you. That's right.
Now he's old right now, but he's looking back on his teenage years.
Yes.
When God told Samuel, go down there and anoint one of Jesse's boys.
Yes.
See, go down there and anoint one of Jesse's boys.
Yes.
So as Sammy was on his way down there and got to the house, Jesse brought seven of his sons up, one at a time. The Bible said one at a time. And the older sons stood up, kind of tall, handsome, strength. Sammy said, this is the one. But the oil will not flow. He got the anointing oil, but it won't flow.
Yeah.
God said he's not the one.
The
second son showed up.
That's right.
But the oil will not flow.
Yes, sir.
The third son showed up. But the oil did not flow.
Yes.
He had the oil now. Not only had all the oil, but he had the oil now. He had the anointing oil, but it wouldn't flow. The fourth son showed up. God said, that's not the one.
That's right.
The oil went flow.
Went
the fifth son comes.
Yes.
But the oil went flow. The sixth son showed up. But the oil wouldn't come out.
Yes.
Come on.
But the seventh son came. The oil wouldn't come out. Second said, Jesse, this all your son? Jesse, that's all your boys. That's why I had a boy in the back and he just tended to sheep. See, go get a blessing. Put your name on it. Nobody can touch it.
That's all right.
When David came to the front, the oil came flowing. From his head down to his bed. Down to the God of his home.
Yes.
God got a blessing.
Yes.
with your name on it.
That's all right.
I'm trying to help somebody.
Yes.
But you got to believe that God got a blessing.
That's right.
With your name on it.
Come on, Pastor.
David was way out yonder over there, minding his own business. Mm-hmm. But God had a blessing.
Yes.
God had a blessing that no one can. But you have to believe in God. You don't have to go to a psychic hotline. You don't have to go to the psychic man to ask about your blessing.
Yes.
You don't have to go to the palm reader to ask about your future. You don't got to old crack over the fortune cookie. You don't have to crack the fortune cookie over or know what's going on.
Yes.
God got blessed with your name on it.
Yes, wow.
You got to ask the right one. You got to ask twice. My sisters and brothers, sent you. God got a blessing with your name on it.
Yes.
No one can jump the line and get your blessing. They can't do it. I thought about Jacob.
Yes.
Jacob? Oh, come in, Jacob. I thought about Jacob. God told Rebecca, Jacob got a blessing with his name on it.
Yes.
When he was in her womb, two twins. Jacob got a blessing with his name on it. Yeah. He told Rebecca. But Rebecca tried to steal.
Yes. I know.
Trying to get Jacob
yes.
to steal the brother's blessing. But you can't steal nobody's blessing.
That's right.
You can't rush y'all. All you have to do is wait on him.
Yes.
Yes, later down the road.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes.
When Esau showed up,
yes.
Jacob saw him. Esau said, I got plenty.
Yes.
I got plenty. I got enough to give you. You can't stop nobody's blessing.
That's right.
Once God has anointed, you can't touch it.
That's right.
You can't touch it.
Can't touch it.
You can't steal it.
Jesus.
No one can stop your blessing except us.
Come on, come on.
No one can stop a spoken your wheel.
Yes.
They can't stop it. As a matter of fact, when God sends down his stored up blessing,
yes.
Guess what? He said it's certified. Certified it is. You got to sign for it. Nobody can accept it but you. Yeah. He said it's terrified. That's it that no man can stop.
Yeah.
I know I'm right about it. God is too wise to make a mistake. Yeah. He will never send a blessing to the wrong address. He's too wise. I don't care if you live in a cul-de-sac subdivision. I don't care if you live in a dead end. That blessing will track you down.
Jesus.
Are there any single people in the house? Or any single people in the house. God has a husband and wife stored up for you.
Yes.
All you gotta do is wait on it.
Wait.
Am I right about it?
Right about it.
Let me tell you a true story.
Oh my.
Let me tell you a true story. Before me and your first lady.
All right.
Before me and her got together.
Yes.
Honey, before we got together,
yes.
She came and visited Charity. Yeah, she came to visit Charity Church. Yeah, I was minding my own business. I was minding my own business. Wasn't bothering nobody. Yeah. But at the end of the service, someone tapped me on the shoulder. So this young lady wanted to say hello to you. But that ain't the story now. I'm going to tell the whole story. She didn't talk me right then. But she told me the friend was going to hook him up with somebody else.
Yes. Tell it, Pastor.
God had my blessing. Put my name on it. Nobody can touch it.
Don't make me come up here.
I told you, you know what? I said, you came for one thing. But God had a blessing. Put my name on it.
Yes.
That's the true story. I'm telling you. Tell me. Yeah, that house you got now,
yeah.
On that corner lot, nobody can get that house but you.
That's right.
Your name was on that.
Come on.
Your name was on that house.
Right.
Oh, yes. Yes. That promotion you got in your job.
Yeah.
That's a stored out blessing that came from the Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know I'm right about it. Stored up blessing.
Yeah.
That promotion you got. Stored up blessing. That healing you got. That's a stored up blessing.
Yes. Jesus.
And I know some of us, we get frustrated when we see God blessing others. Oh yeah, I know he gets hurt. We're human.
That's right.
So where ain't God going to bless me?
Tell it, Pastor.
The old folk will tell you, stay in his will.
Stay
in God's will, and he will bless you.
Yes.
We got blessing coming. God never runs out of blessings.
Yes, Jesus.
That's right.
Let me speak to Central for a moment.
Mm.
Central.
Come on, Pastor.
I was in discouragement. God took me back to Moses.
Yes, yes.
When the Israelites were in bondage over 400 years,
yes, yes.
God told Moses, I heard they tried.
Come on, Pastor.
So I heard their prayers over the years.
Jesus.
And I've come to rescue them.
Yes.
God said, I'm going to bring them out to a land with milk and honey.
Yes.
Say, I'm going to bring them out. What is God saying? God, I got some stored up blessing for Israelites.
Yeah.
And as they were leaving Egypt, as they were going, they had their leavened bread, they had their baked cake, they had everything getting out of town. I can imagine over about 2 million of the Israelites coming out of there. The Bible says they had over 600,000 men, not including the women and the children. So scholars believe over 2 million people were coming out of there. And Moses had to lead those people.
Yes, he did. Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Moses had to lead them. He had to lead them.
Yeah.
But notice this. Notice this.
Yeah.
God did not lead Israelites through the Philistine country. Though that was the shortest route.
Come on. Yes, sir.
God took the long route. God said, I'm going to take the parking lot the long route. God said, I'm going to take the long route. Because if you take the long route, you will know me better. God said, I'm going to take the long route. I'm not going to take the short route.
Right.
So the long route tests our faith.
That's right. Yes, sir.
The long route. We say, do we really know God for himself? That's the long route. The long route was strengthening you and my faith. Take the long route. I was in despair. The short route is not always the best route.
Yes.
The short route is not always the safest route. But God got the best route.
Yes.
And God said, Central, I heard your cries years ago. And I caught them up. Got a blessing with your name on it. But I'm going to take you the long road. You got a blessing. God, I heard your prayer over the years. Yes. Yes. But as the Israelites were coming out of Egypt, what happened? What happened? They were trapped between the Red Sea and the wilderness. Am I right about it? They were trapped. They were trapped between the Red Sea and the wilderness. So what happened?
Jesus.
Pharaoh army started coming. Pharaoh army started coming. They saw the army coming. And they started looking at the numbers.
Jesus.
They started looking at the numbers.
Put it together.
Moses had to deal with 2 million people. They told Moses, he said, let us in Egypt. Because they were looking at the numbers of Pharaoh's soldiers. And sometimes we get fearful. I know. I get fearful myself. But I know the one who can multiply the number. Oh yeah. I got to preach. I got to encourage somebody today. God got a blessing.
Jesus.
With our names on it.
Yeah.
He got a blessing. With our name on it.
Yes.
And check sometimes. When we want to claim our our promises,
yes,
when we want to claim our blessing, sometimes Satan get us a little scared.
Yes, he does. Mm-hmm.
Get us fearful for the unknown.
Yes.
That's the human side of us.
That's right.
They were perplexed.
Hallelujah.
And they were anxious and jumping, and that's all right.
Mm-hmm.
But Moses told them, don't worry about it.
Yes.
Jesus. Moses said, God got us.
Yes.
Yes,
sir. So keep the faith.
Yes.
Keep the faith.
Yes, sir.
The people's side won't come out.
Mm-hmm.
They start saying, why you bring us way out of here to die?
Yes.
That's the human side.
That's right.
Moses said, don't fail. God hasn't given us better fail,
yes,
but power,
mm-hmm,
love,
wow,
and a sound mind. Since I got to finish the story,
mm-hmm,
I got to finish the story.
Yes.
Moses told them to stand firm.
Yes.
Later on, Moses sent 12 spies. God said, this is yours.
Jesus.
This is your stored up blessing.
Mm-hmm.
God said, go get it. This is yours. But when they went there,
Jesus,
12 spies saw the man with milk and honey.
Yes, sir.
They saw it. But 10 of them, but looking at the number.
Yes.
The giants, looking at the number.
Yes.
They were looking at the number.
Yes.
Nothing wrong with looking at the number.
Uh-huh.
But let God do the multiplication.
Yes.
Took 2 bits of fish and 5 loaves of bread.
Yes.
What I do with the number, I give it to God. He's the number man.
Yes.
He is the one,
yes,
who can change life. He is the one who can change history.
Yeah.
He is the one,
yeah,
who knows it all. He is the one,
yeah,
all power, all power. Yeah, he is the one. Yes,
yeah,
yes. But 2 of them in the crowd,
mm,
so we certainly can do it.
Yes.
We can do it.
Yes, sir.
Peter was fishing all night one night. Didn't catch anything.
Mm.
The number man showed up.
Come on.
Yes, sir.
So Peter, all right,
throw your net over here. Peter said,
Jesus,
the number ain't right.
Hallelujah.
I ain't caught nothing.
Mm. All night.
All night long.
Yes.
No fish in that water.
Mm.
But the number man showed up. Peter,
yes,
Peter,
yes,
cast back him.
Yes.
Cast it, Peter. Cast it, Peter.
Yes.
Cast it, Peter.
Yes.
When Peter cast it,
yes,
the overflow of the fish.
Yes.
Peter had a call, another boat. I'm all finished. Our God is a mountain mover.
Yes.
Our God,
yes,
there's no mountain high enough,
mm,
that God can't reach way down,
yes,
and pick us up. There's no valley,
mm,
low enough,
yes,
that God can't come to our rescue.
Yes.
There's no river wide enough to keep God from us. No wind,
no wind,
no storm,
yes,
no hurricane,
yes,
no disturbance,
yes,
no distraction,
yes,
no interference can separate us,
yes,
from the love of God.
And
I like the way Paul put it. Paul said, I'm persuaded,
yes,
that nothing can keep us from the love of God. Neither death,
yes,
nor life,
yes,
nor angels, nor demons. Neither height nor depth can keep us away from God.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And sometimes,
sometime,
God will give us the stored up blessing all at one time.
That's right.
For a reason.
Word right there.
That particle, son.
Yes.
Got all the blessing,
yeah,
at one time.
Yes.
But we find out in the text,
yes,
the particle, son, one time.
Yes.
He got all the blessing, but he ain't had no faith at all.
Right.
He got the blessing,
yes,
had no relationship with God at all.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Oh, God, thank God. That prodigal son came to his senses. Huh? He came to the senses. And I thank God. My father, the father was standing there. Come on home.
Yeah.
When the father told him, I got some stored up blessing waiting on you.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. I don't care. In spite of our fault, in spite of our shortcomings,
yes,
in spite of our mistakes, in spite of all bad decisions,
yeah,
in spite of disobedience,
yeah,
in spite of us doing the wrong thing,
uh-huh,
God still got a blessing,
yeah,
with our name on it.
Yeah. Thank you.
That father told the servant, put a ring, put a robe on him. Stored up blessing number one,
yeah,
put a ring on his finger. Stored up blessing number two, put some shoes on his feet. Going up blessing number three, kill a calf. Blessing number four, spread the table. Blessing number five, it was going up just waiting for him to come back to the Lord. Am I right about it? That's why you see people shouting, getting their shot on. They're talking something about stole up blessing about to come. Sometimes people shout, leave them alone. That's not that something that I stole our blessing that just came their way.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Stored up blessing. Stored up blessing.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
The woman with an issue of blood.
Yes.
12 long years.
Mm.
She said, if I press my way on,
yes,
God got a blessing with my name on it.
Yes.
That's what she said. God got a blessing with my name on it. And she pressed him away through the crowd.
Yes.
You got to claim your blessing. The man who's living in the cemetery has some bad days, has some up and down days.
Yes.
But he knew God had a blessing with his name on it. The man was clothed in his right mind when Jesus touched him. Am I right about it?
Yes, you are.
Old man Joe will tell you, God got a blessing,
yes,
with your name on it.
Yes.
He might be running a little late with the human point of view, but he'll be but from God's point of view. He's on time.
Yes.
Joe lost everything. Lost his children, lost his family, his wife kept kicked, God and died,
yes,
lost his wealth, lost his friends. But at the end of the day, Joe will tell you, God got a blessing with your name on it.
Stored up blessing.
Hallelujah.
That's why the Pharisees,
come on.
They got mad at Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus was hanging with the tax collectors and sinners.
Come on.
And they got jealous.
Yes.
Because God had a blessing with the sinner's name on it.
Yes. Jesus.
Listen, we've been in the world all the time. Where did it come from?
Say it again.
We got to learn how to celebrate other people's blessings.
That's right. Yes. That's right.
Now, when you go to the prodigal son, they got an older son in the picture.
Mm-hmm.
And when they had the fast, they had a family feast. He didn't came to the family feast.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't understand about stored up blessings.
Yeah.
And many people don't understand, but store our blessing.
That's right.
God blesses who you want to bless.
That's right.
Mm. When you want to bless.
That's
yes.
right.
And he do it his own time.
Yes.
Yes.
But he's all time God.
Yes.
He's all time God.
All time.
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 All time God.
All time,
all time God.
Yes.
He's worthy.
Worthy.
He's worthy.
Worthy.
He's worthy.
Yeah.
He's worthy.
Jesus.
Even Jesus. Even Jesus. Even Jesus.
Jesus.
Even Jesus.
Yes.
Have him. stored up blessing. Yes. Even Jesus had some stored up blessing as he was carrying the cross.
Yes.
I stored up blessing came. A man by name Simon. Simon showed up. Helped him carry the cross. That was a stored up blessing. If the truth be told, Simon, a black man, helped him carry the cross. I stored up blessing. Lord, I'm going down there and help my son. Jesus told the world, I can call my fathers. My fathers and 12 legions of angels. He talked about a stored up blessing.
Yes. Hallelujah. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Central, God got a blessing.
Yes, sir.
With your name on it.
Amen.
Yes.
Trust the process.
Yes.
Trust the process.
Thank you, Father.
Single people, check it. Claim the process.
Yes.
The husband, that wife, will show up. Keep praying, daughter.
Right.
Keep doing the right thing. And watch God bless you. Come right your way.
My Lord. Hallelujah.
We walk by faith. And not by sight.
That's right, Pastor.
Amen.
That's a word right there.
Hallelujah. By faith, yes,
Jesus.
And let God do the multiply.
Yes, he will.
That's his job. My job is just to walk by faith. And not by sight. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you.
Hallelujah.
There may be someone today,
Jesus,
who don't understand about the stored up blessing.
Yes.
Like our older son in a part of the story. Maybe you don't understand about the stored up blessing. Maybe you don't have that right relationship with the Lord. The Bible said you believe that Jesus is the Son of God and believe that he died for your sins and believe that God raised him up from the grave 3 days, you're saved. You cannot fix yourself. You cannot change yourself. Come as you are and surrender. Give it all to God. And I'm not going to sit there and tell you that life is easy.
That's right.
I'm not going to sit there and tell you that every day is going to be Sunday when you join the church. I'm not going to tell you every day is going to be a good day. But I know one thing. I don't know what tomorrow holds. But I know who holds the future. That is Jesus. All you have to do is confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead and you saved you. You can reach us by Facebook or call the church and leave a message and we will get back with you as soon as possible. God has blessing stored up for you. He don't care how far. He will meet you where you are in life. He will meet you where you are at.
Yes, he will.
When I came to him, I was broken and weary.
Yes.
Couldn't see the light. Things were gloomy.
Yes.
And mom told me, try Jesus, son. And I tried Jesus for myself. And I'm a witness today. I've never been the same.
Hallelujah.
But you got to try it for yourself.
Yes.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. God bless you.
Yes.
Heaven smile upon you. God keep you.
Turn it back into the handle. Always out.
Elevate.